Vladimir Putin is carrying through on something that he's been warning us about at least in the last 15 years, which is that he will not tolerate U.S. forces or their missiles on his borders, much as we would not tolerate Russian troops and missiles in Cuba. And we ignored him, and he finally acted. He was not going to allow Ukraine under any circumstances to join NATO. What's happened now is the battle in eastern Ukraine is really almost over. All the Ukrainian troops there have been largely surrounded and cut off. You have a concentration down in the southeast of 30 to 40,000 of them. And if they don't surrender within the next 24 hours, I suspect that the Russians will ultimately annihilate them. That's why Zelensky is meeting with Putin's representatives right now. The game is over. And he's going to have to negotiate the best deal he can get. And we've already told him, the President of the United States says, that if he opts for neutrality for Ukraine, he'll back it. And I think that Vladimir Putin will do that for Western Ukraine. That is the Ukraine beyond the Upper River. But behind it in the east where he is now, I'm not sure what he has planned there, whether he forms another republic, annexes it into Russia, because historically it has been Russian. He has no interest in crossing the west of the Dnieper and heading west of the Polish border. I think